Hello, I'm EnterElysium, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4 as Democratic Denmark. A couple of people have been asking, like, well, aren't we basically playing fascist Denmark? I mean, you know, you took land and stuff. Well, for a start, most powers around this sort of time did take land and so on like this. Also, we couldn't really be a faction without having taken part of Germany. We'd still have, you know, 8 troops or whatever. There'd be no way we'd actually be taking part in a worldwide conflict, so we had to take land from them. Anyway, we're continuing fighting Comintern, basically the Soviet Union at the moment. We managed to grab a load of land up here and surround their forces. We're just going to try and hold this. And otherwise, we're trying to do similar down here, which I believe we may have succeeded in. Have we? We keep fighting that point. We keep winning, but I don't know if we've actually taken it yet. Alright, hit that. Hit it. Come on. Take it. I mean, they're racing us with tanks as well. Light cruiser. Yeah, they got there. We got it. Right. Okay, so now they're trapped. And that really helps with our line. A lot less to worry about. Right. What do we need to import? Tungsten. Of course we do. And another light cruiser at 50% research time. Very nice. Okay, that's sorted. Still a bit of a gap there that we need to plug, but other than that, we're doing fine. Over here, yeah, they're trying to attack troops. Thank you for that. We'll just push them in a few other places, make them feel the pain that they've done. Might well succeed in this assault, but it doesn't really matter. Every time they attack, they're using equipment which they can't replace. They don't have anywhere to get replacement stuff from. I don't know quite why you're attacking that there, just attacking them in the strongest point, but sure, whatever. Anyone else? Attack there. This is 2 troops, and I think we'll leave the rest because they'll be strong enough that I'm not really going to poke them. Right. How are we doing down here? Oh, you're ready to go. Straight up. No organization, basically no equipment. Crush there. Crush there. All the while driving into mountains, which is why it's taking a while. How many bombs we got? We got 2 bombs. And no manpower to replace our losses, but oh well. Come on, let me select. Thank you. Right. I'll free up some units down there. Oh, hello here. What are you doing? No, 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 mate. No, no, that's not allowed. Get out of there. Rather well, aren't they? Let's get a tank over here. There we go. It's not made a massive difference. Yeah, look at them, they're starting to lack, is that organization? Of course. Organization, yeah, and the that one's equipment. Or strength. What do you want to give me? Wow, 42 divisions. Netherlands. Thank you. Straight up. I'll organize them in a little bit. I want to finish this pocket first, otherwise it'll be a bit messy. Right, how are we doing with control of the airspace? Yeah, we need to move the Western Poland forces forwards. There we go. Anyone else? HRC is not us. Here, we do have people in the area. Middle East, surprisingly, not anymore, actually. We'll probably actually burn those planes, and by burn them, I mean throw them away and replace them with close air support. Are you ready to be rattled over yet? Almost. Yeah, you are. We can wipe you out. Oh, hello. Look at that. Audacious. But well done. We need to support that as much as we can. If they do that breakthrough. These are basically a distraction. I'm sorry, but the manpower is going to be burned. We need to get this, like, success. This would cut off this entire section. That's actually a really good move by the AI there. I didn't notice that. That was a good call. You can see that our troops are starting to have organization and attrition losses and their strength's going down. Here we go. Move in. If you wouldn't mind. Right. We'll let them starve for a little bit longer. Now, if we can hold this line, we're good. We have to take the capital, because if we can take the capital, they won't be getting reinforcements, because they get, not reinforcements, they get, like, organization and stuff, whatever. Their supply lines derive from cities. So if we can take the city, the easiest way in is from this side. Should be good. Alright, got tank there. Got infantry joining in. Oh, hello. Yes, send it. Yes, send it. Send it. Not much, but it'll help. Researching the last one there. Could do synthetic oil and get the rubber, but again, I don't think it's really important. Again, there's nothing really we need to massively research. We could do this because it buffs our rocket support artillery. And motorized rocket artillery, sure, yeah. Buff rockets. Why not? There we go, we overran and we got the capital. Any other cities that we should grab? I don't think so, actually. Up here. Yeah, we should try and grab that if we can, but it's going to be well defended. I could nuke it. I can't nuke it right now, but I could. I'll put effort into it. How are we doing up here? They want to break through. They want to break through. Nope, not allowed. And yeah, this is ripe for plucking. Yeah, they're just gone. Straight up. That is a massive win for us. That's a massive overrun. Why have we got spare manpower? I mean, it disappeared very quick. I guess because that was the manpower tick or something. Right, let's just select everyone up here. Make sure they're attached. Everyone here, make sure you're attached. Yeah, we're getting a few more there because I'm picking up a lot of the people who have been added recently. Another light cruiser. Yeah, we got that. Right, just going to let them starve. Any more land we can take with them makes it quicker. So I've got to keep an eye out for that. I'll try and make an infiltration attempt there. And although they were leaving, we'll try and catch them here. Why can I not tell you to do that? Odd. Right, go in there. Just start chopping them up. Go, move you in there. You can help support that attack there. We should have this one in the bag, I think. Right, up here. How you doing? Yeah, I think we could push that front. It's like, oh, it's risky. It's like, really? There are like four units in that area. We've got lots more. I mean, you're already winning half the battles. Oh, hello. Someone just ran ahead and got Leningrad. And is making me help cover it. Oh, thank you for that, Britain. You ass. Right, they're shifting a lot of their units around. Radio detection. I think we could hit them already, actually. There we go. Winning all along the front. It's a very slow going process trying to like take out certain parts of the infrastructure, etc. We could get radar. It doesn't really serve purpose at this point because we're advancing. Radar's great for defense because you need to set it up. We'll grab one of these. Sure, naval stuff. Right, Albert, we're kicking that ass. Oh, we're fourth. There we go. They're going to be overrun. There we go. Oh, I like how overrun just goes up because there's just so many of the overrun word all overlaid on top of each other. So lovely. All right, we need to hit them hard enough that we can get into this inner core that they've left undefended because they're worried. Right, hit them here. Hit them here. And I'd like to hit them in the third place. They're hitting me now. Yeah, cunning. Trying to hold me down. Not going to work. Right. I'm going to try pushing up to there. Oh, I didn't really intend that, but whatever. Go there and then go up there. They're falling back here, and we're still hitting that pretty hard. Overrun. Lovely. This is why I love motorized. Just like, yeah, I don't care. I'm overrunning you. Come on, I want to select these guys. There we go. Just hit you. Yeah, you've tried to make a run out here, but whatever. I'll kill you. Feels so good to finally be able to steamroll some units. Quite consistently steamrolling as well. Against a much bigger foe. And we have no manpower. Our units are actually suffering quite heavily in terms of losses. Every time a unit goes into battle and it loses people, those people are not being replaced now. And I don't think there is any way that they can be replaced. I think we've maxed it out quite considerably. Okay, so we got Leningrad. How close are we to Moscow? Like, we need fighter coverage to get that. Here's the thing. If we use our air experience to buff our fighter jets, how far are we away from Jet Fighter 2? Yeah, so if we use our air experience to buff the range on fighter jet, we might be able to fly over Moscow. If we can fly over Moscow and nuke it... I'm feeling it. Oh, and yeah, you need to just murder. Straight up murder. A run, and up here. Come on. Done. Excellent. Right, let's grab everyone on the southern front now. We now have 203 units in this army. Let's go check on Turkey. Doing fine. Managed to wipe out the bit down there. Definitely thinner than they were, but look at this. That attrition. We're going to have issues taking these ones on. The attrition is really high. What is your issue? What do you need? Current fighting strength, 98%, blah, 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 blah. Can I check, like, your manpower? Like, how much manpower do you have at what you want? Just your organization's really low. Okay, whatever. I might need to start spanning a few units, but I need to start, like, quite a lot. Interesting tactic here, but it's just opening up my front and I don't have the numbers for that. I know you're like, oh, well, the Soviets don't have the numbers for that either. I mean, I don't care. Like, I don't have the numbers for that, straight up. Is this a... This has got 6 fort level and they're just letting it go. Thank you. Why do you have to go around to do that? Is it like a... Oh, there's a tiny little lake here. Oh, it actually encompasses. Okay. They've left parts of the front wide open. Let's be aggressive. That means that any time they see a part of the front open, they'll take it. Anytime they think they can take a battle, they'll take it. We're fighting into a fort there, so I'm not sure why, but, you know, to each their own. We have nukes if we need them. What I think we do is we nuke Kiev, we nuke Minsk, because, you know, those are on our front line anyway. We're going to need to shift forwards from... Okay, apparently someone is protecting Western Poland, it's not us. Shift you to... Can't use that. You will fit in there, okay. Fly over Belarus. That's over capacity. Not that capacity really matters, because we just need a strategic bomber up. And then we've got strategic bomber 3. There we go, jet strategic bomber. Now, the downside on this is we're going to need to disband someone. I think we have actually a few people we could disband. We have some strategic bombers around that I don't want to use anymore because they're normal strategic bombers. So we'll scrap you. And then out of this airport, jet strategic bombers. We only need like 20. And then to hit Kiev, which is in the Ukraine, we just need to have any of these airports near the front line. Really? Or we could use this one here. There we go. You need to be deployed in Ukraine. You need to be deployed in Belarus. Bomb stuff. Bomb stuff. Then we need to get a fighter deployed in Belarus. And to be honest, we're pretty much out of the Balkans. Okay, we don't actually have anyone in the Balkans. Czechoslovakia. There we go. We've got some people in Czechoslovakia. Totally not needed. They won't fit in that airport. It's not airport. It's an aerodrome. Nope. Yes, but too far away. Nope. Nope. If I grab it, yes, but... Oh, there we go. Right. And when they're established and we have air superiority, we'll nuke them. Minsk. Kiev. That'll reduce the national unity. Hopefully. Be a good start. I mean, I would have nuked Leningrad if I could, but... What are you doing? Why are you just pushing on this way? Oh god, it's insane. We'll start on synthetic oil because we might as well. How's your national unity doing now, Soviet Union? 80%. What? No, 44. There we go. I must have clicked someone else. 44. That's much better. Right. How close are you to surrendering, out of interest? 11%. Yeah, we just basically haven't got deep enough into the territory. We need to start hitting this area here. Look at those, you know, towns and stuff. Moscow, of course, would be great. We might be able to drive for Moscow. They don't actually have many forces. And if we get a good solid core of motorized, we might be able to just tell them to sprint for it. I wonder... 17 selected. Drive for Moscow. Can I, like, order this by... I can't really select a certain number of divisions. Like, I would like to select motorized and just be like, look, motorized, just push. Like, you can probably quite easily punch out and make us break for it, and I'm pretty sure that people cover you. You can make a break for Kiev if you can. And then, where is the next target? It's actually very close to the front. There's Minsk. Yeah, you make a break for Minsk. And that's our new tactic. Throwing bodies at the wall. It's going to be very painful, but it might result in an early win for us if we can pull it off. I've been at EnterElysium. If you enjoyed, please like, not subscribe. Please consider subscribing. And until next time, stay shiny.